In this screencast, I'm going to introduce a few properties of ideal gases, and one way of determining if something is an ideal gas is if it behaves the ideal gas law. Now, this can be written a couple ways. Common way is PV is nRT, where this is the total volume, this is absolute pressure, and very important, this is absolute temperature, for example, Kelvin. And of course, R is the gas constant. However, it's also fairly common to write it this way, where this is a specific volume. So what we mean by that, this might be liters per mole, for example. Because there are three variables in this equation, we have to be careful what we conclude. For example, if I were to raise the temperature, that doesn't necessarily mean the pressure goes up. It could be the volume goes up. It could be both pressure and volume change. Depends on our system. So if I were in a piston cylinder and I raise the temperature goes up, then the volume would also increase. If I were in a fixed volume container, well, now the volume can't change. So when the temperature goes up, the pressure goes up. Well, one important property of an ideal gas is we can write a change in enthalpy in terms of heat capacity and a temperature change. So I'm writing this for constant values of heat capacity. We also, for internal energy, so this is called the constant pressure heat capacity, and this is called the constant volume heat capacity. But these equations are good for ideal gases at all times. And this is true because the H and U are independent of pressure for an ideal gas. So one other aspect of the values for CP and CV results because H is U plus PV, just the definition of enthalpy. So delta H is delta U plus delta PV. Keep in mind the notation here, all of these terms are per mole. And from our ideal gas law, that means I can write this as delta U plus delta RT. I can write delta H as CP delta T. I can write delta U as CV delta T. And the right side, since R is a constant, becomes R delta T. Now you can see I can cross out delta T, and this says constant pressure heat capacity is the constant volume heat capacity plus the ideal gas constant. Another aspect of ideal gases is if we look at gas mixtures, and for example, let's say we just have two components, then the total pressure in our system would be the partial pressure of A plus the partial pressure of B, where, for example, if we just start out with A in a fixed volume container, we exert a certain pressure. If we now added B to that same fixed volume container, it would exert pressure. The pressure of A would not change because ideal gases, molecules A, if you like, don't even know molecules B are there. And of course, the mole fraction of A then is the pressure of A over the total pressure. So these are important aspects of ideal gases that we should keep in mind when we're doing calculations on ideal gases.